Hey there, you lovely people. Welcome to the Holy Shed, where it's raining, I can tell you. I mean, not in here, but I can hear it on the shed roof. I don't know if you can. It's raining quite a lot at the moment. And this is the Holy Shedlet for Lent number 6, which is about a diamond geezer. I'd like to think that was me, but it isn't actually who I'm talking about. Someone once asked me, Dave, how would you like to be remembered in one sentence? It's a great question, isn't it? I mean, you should try answering it for yourself sometimes. It's hard, but it's a good sentence, a good question. My immediate response, and I've seen no reason to change it ever since, was I'd like people to say that Dave Tomlinson was a kind person. And if that was the only thing I had on my gravestone, he was a kind person. That would do it for me. Now, hey, it may not sound very ambitious, but I just hope that I can live up to it because, A, I think it's one of the greatest things that you can say about anyone, and B, I work in a profession that, frankly, isn't always known for its kindness. And maybe that's partly because religion itself isn't always that kind. The God represented in religion, even in the Bible in places, is at times distinctly unkind. And I can't believe in that sort of God. I cannot believe in a God who is not kind. Because something deep down in me, I think it's deep down in everyone, tells us that being kind is the right thing, that being kind is good, it's the way we're supposed to be. So when people convey an image of God that's unkind, or when they try to tell me about God, even a good God, in a not very kind way, well, I just want to tell them, in a very kind way, to sod off. Because I'm way past the point in my life where I can be doing with religion or a God that's basically inhumane. To rephrase the question I was asked, you know, if someone asked me to summarise in one word what my entire life's work and ministry was about, well, I'd have no doubt. I would immediately say grace, grace, because that's my core understanding of what God or faith or just being human is really all about, grace. And I was always told that it meant unmerited favour. But I found that actually quite a difficult concept, when in fact grace was preached conditionally. You know, like if you believe this, or if you believe that, or if you sign up to become part of us, then you will receive God's grace. I mean, what? What? How does that even work? Especially when the next sentence maybe says, oh, and if you don't believe and join us, God's going to let you burn in hell forever. Well, I say again, dear Shedsters, very kindly, sod off. If the good news of Jesus means anything at all, it means grace. It means unmerited favour or unconditional love. One of my most concerted efforts, I would say, for years and years, has been to get people to believe this, to believe that they are loved unconditionally, that acceptance isn't something that you have to earn in any shape or form, including, by the way, by believing in Jesus or going to church or whatever. I believe divine love is unilateral. Well, actually, that's what grace means, isn't it? Isn't it? I mean, unmerited favour means you're loved unilaterally. That's the very heart of what grace is all about, unilateral love. And I've spent, as I say, hours and hours and hours over the years trying to encourage people to believe this, to cast themselves into the arms of love, to trust in divine grace. I'd like to read you a poem by Denise Levertov, whose work I am a big fan of. And this poem, it's one of her shortest, and it's called The Avowal, which means an affirmation, something that I really deeply believe. And it goes like this. I'll put the words on the screen for you. As swimmers dare to lie face to the sky and water bears them, as swimmers dare to lie face to the sky and water bears them, as hawks rest upon air and sustains them, so would I learn to attain free fall and float into Creator Spirit's deep embrace, knowing no effort earns that all-surrounding grace. I mean, that's flipping potent, really, you know. It's worth reading over several times. What beautiful imagery as well. You know, lying face to the sky in the water. Something that's really easy once you've done it, but bloody scary when you're trying to do it for the first time. Or the picture of hawks, you know, resting upon the air, sustained by, well, not much, so it seems. I would love to attain free fall, she says, and float into Creator Spirit's deep embrace, knowing no effort earns that all-surrounding grace. It's almost a year now, back in lockdown number one, since we said goodbye to a beautiful friend, a 93-year-old wonderful soul called Maurice Smith. And if anyone taught me about grace, it was Maurice Smith. I treasure an email that he sent me about a month before he died, the last communication I had from him, just a few weeks, as I say, before he died, in which he wrote this. He says, Dave, I pass your book, Black Sheep, around the village. He lived in a little village near Canterbury. I pass your book, excuse me, around the village. One of my carers, an ex-regular Grenadier's Guard, returned it today, deeply touched. He's a lovely man who would not go near a silly church. Very typical Maurice. He kept quoting you. Maybe it was your picture with the pint of Bess that really grabbed him, he says. But you know what? The reality, I mean, I treasure that. It's such a lovely affirmation from Maurice. But the reality is, the understanding of God that Maurice imparted to me over many, many years is so deeply interwoven into the fabric of who I am that I could never unravel it. I think Denise Levertov's poem is the epitome of Maurice's life, a life cast into the Creator Spirit's embrace, knowing that no effort earns that all-surrounding grace. Among other things, he wrote a fabulous little book called This Is It, The Art of Happily Going Nowhere. A title, eh? The Art of Happily Going Nowhere. It's about mindfulness, really, but without all of that kind of trendy jargon. So many people find that the faith that they've inherited seems basically to require so much of them. When I wrote How to Be a Bad Christian, you know, I was met by wave after wave of people saying something like, huh, that's me. You know, people who felt in some way that they have failed to be a good Christian. They've never really made the cut. And, you know, over the years, I've discovered that there are so many people who feel that way. I think grace and kindness are cut from exactly the same cloth. They're different ways of saying the same thing, really. To me, this is the very nub of what faith really means. It's about trust, but it's about trust in that unmerited, unconditional love of God, abandoning oneself into the arms of infinite kindness, with no need to hide anything, nothing to live up to, nothing to earn, just the realization that you are loved. So just picture yourself lying out, face up to the sky on the pool, borne up by the love of God, knowing that you are completely accepted just as you are. Maurice was my diamond geezer that I'm talking about, really, but I want to finish with a song by another diamond geezer, Neil Diamond Geezer, and a song that often makes me cry with joy when I listen to it and cockeyed with gratitude. It's called Pretty Amazing Grace. I love it, and I hope you do too as I play it to you now. So see you soon. Stay human. Bye.
Thank you so much. This one's called Pretty Amazing Grace. Pretty amazing grace is what you showed me. Pretty amazing grace is who you are. I was an empty vessel, you filled me up inside, and with amazing grace restored my pride. Pretty amazing grace is how you saved me, and with amazing grace reclaimed my heart. Love in the midst of chaos, calm in the heat of war, showed with amazing grace what love was for. You forgave my insensitivity and my intent to then mislead you. You stood beside a wretch like me, show your amazing grace. When grace was what I needed, stumbled inside the doorway of your chapel, humbled and awed by everything I found. Beauty and love surround me, freed me from what I fear. Ask for amazing grace and you appear.